We can see, you see the picture is being dragged from one point to another. Now let's see other use cases of our drag and drop. Now I'll show you an example. I have this picture. Just give me a second, let me set it. Okay, now I have this picture. I want to drag it from this point to this point. Okay, so I drag it, you see, very easy. How am I able to achieve that? To use drag and drop, click, left click on an icon once, left click on an icon once, left click on it, you keep your mouse, keep your hand on it, you mouse down on it, then you drag to your desired position. Okay, use your index finger, take the mouse pointer, place it on the icon, then click the left mouse button once. Okay, if you notice, you see a blue highlighted color. Now drag to a particular position. That is what drag and drop. Let's see the other use cases of double click. What do you mean by double click? By clicking the left mouse button twice, we can use double click to open a folder. You can use double click to open a program. Now look at it, look at this picture that I have here. I want to open this picture, so I will double click on it by clicking the left mouse button twice without wasting time. So if you listen properly, you get the click sound. It has opened the picture. Okay, very easy for me. Now look at this page, index.html. Take your mouse pointer, place it on it, double click on the left mouse button. Double click means clicking on it what, twice. So without wasting time, I double click on it. Now we have it what, open. Okay, now how do I use drag and drop? I use drag and drop. I can click on it once, I drag. Click on it once, then you drag. Sorry. Click on it once, you drag. Click on it once, you drag. How do you left click? Left click is by clicking on the left mouse button once. Once you click on the left mouse button once, you see it will be what? Highlighted. You see it will be what? Highlighted. This means you have selected an item. I want to select this precious folder. I'll take my mouse pointer, click on it once, you see it has been what, highlighted. I want to select Benson file. Now I'll take my my mouse pointer, place the cursor on the Benson file, and click the left mouse button once. Once I click it, it will be selected. You see it's been surrounded by a light blue color. This shows that that icon or that program has been what, selected. You see, I'm clicking, I'm pressing the left mouse button once. Now if I want to open it, I double click on it. Once I double click on it, the program with what, open. What, why do we use right click? We use right click to open a folder or a program. If you use right click, you will see other menu in your right click button. How will you do that? Take your mouse cursor, place it on the icon or the folder, whatever you want to open. Let me use this. Where is Benson? Look at Benson. I take my mouse cursor, place it on it, then I right click. When I right click, I'll see menu items, list of items that are here, and I can do whatever I want to do. If I want to open it, I can open. Okay, if I want to cut it, I can cut. If I want to copy, I can copy. If I want to delete, I can what, delete. How do you right click? Take your mouse pointer, the cursor, place it on the icon or the file or the folder or the program that you wish to open or to perform an action. Then you press the right mouse button once. It will bring list of items for you on the screen. So that's the use cases of your left click, right click, double click, drag and drop. Okay, and all these are what, mouse actions. What are the mouse actions? We have the left click, we have the right click, we have the double click, and we have our what, drag and drop. Drag and drop. Now, okay, now let's learn something else. We've just learned one input device, which is the what, the mouse. Let's look at what, the keyboard. Let's look at another input device, which is the what, the